I'm Thomas Breeze Marcus, originally from Phoenix, Arizona, by the way of the Salt River community, but I'm also an enrolled member of the Tohono O'odham Nation. This weekend we executed this mural. It's probably 95% done. Got a couple more hours to go, but yeah, the whole idea was to do a live mural for the herd market, and I think it's a great addition. Don't really get to see too many things like that anywhere really, so I think hats off to the herd and for including such a large scale piece. I think was a big chance to take, but again, props to the museum. The mural is entitled The Power of Mother Earth, and it's inspired and influenced by seeing the natural world out of balance, and more so human beings out of balance, and then being reminded in a very harsh way that we don't own anything. Basically, the inspiration for is natural disasters and things like that. You know, heavy weather storms to super cold storms to dry desert air, no rain, no water, hurricanes, tsunamis, tornadoes, you name it. That's the power of Mother Earth. And in my feelings about it, it's her reminding us who she is, who's in charge, and who we are. And a part of me feels like she knows that she's being mistreated, and so she has to remind us once in a while. Unfortunately, it costs, costs a lot of lives, or just who knows, whatever the case may be, but people are affected by it. And so it's more of a tribute to her, but a reminder to ourselves that we need to find that daily balance in our lives and get back to the natural, get in touch with the natural world. Well, I probably started messing with graffiti 20 years ago and did a good amount of my fair share of graffiti in the city and other cities, and then maybe about 6 or 7 years ago started making the transition from just graffiti lettering to more abstract styles like the line work, and wanting to create more community murals and not so much with a graffiti style, which I still love and appreciate, even if it's a permission wall or sanctioned area. It'll always be one of my first loves. Never really go completely away from it. Still practice letters once in a while. Still know plenty of graffiti artists that do lettering. But yeah, so a combination of murals and fine art probably since 2007, 2008. The mural art scene has probably taken off since about that time. I could only think of a handful of muralists back when me and some other friends were starting to try and go the mural route. And luckily it caught on like wildfire. Now, I mean, you go to any other city, Los Angeles, San Francisco, New York, and other countries, they've had murals for 20, 30, 40, 50, even longer than that, you know, sometimes a couple centuries of murals. And I think that we've always had this connection as tribal people, indigenous people, for creating work in a general area of public space. I mean, one of my biggest influences is the old petroglyphs on the mountains around the area. So to me, and being related to those ancestors as it is, really finding that connection and finding myself when I paint a wall, it's almost as if I'm connecting to those ancestors, but at the same time, for our people, really reclaiming the area and the land for our own cultural identity, but in a contemporary way. In Salt River, me and a good friend of mine, Dwayne Manuel, who's an artist as well, we started a summer youth program last year, and it went really well. And one of my biggest inspirations to want to do that was to notice how much art really lacked in our community, how many outlets and programs really were non-existent. And when I think of going to places like New Mexico and people out there just born and bred to be artists, where in my own community where I grew up, it didn't seem so much that way. So I really wanted to implement something that would not only act as an outlet for the kids to find a creative expression, but also to steer any at-risk youth away from any negative involvement with illegal graffiti or things that might get them in trouble, or basically get so they're not facing harsh consequences and not have to learn the hard way. So, but it's going well, and we're going to have our second summer program this coming summer, and we're really looking forward to it. Yes, the one thing I'd like to add is all thanks to the museum, and I hope that more of these walls get painted here. And on top of that, but I think incorporating youth programs as well, I think that'd be a great thing to do.